Good morning, children. Welcome to the English class. In the previous video, I have discussed the meaning of noun and its first type, that is common noun, with you. Today, the main objective of my class is to teach you the meaning of proper noun with examples. Now, I will tell you the meaning of proper noun. Proper noun refers to the name of a specific person, a place, or a thing. It always begins with a capital letter. Let us discuss some examples of proper noun. First is Harry Potter. Harry Potter is the name of a specific person, so proper noun. Number two, Australia. Australia is the name of a specific place, so proper noun. Number third, Christmas. Christmas is the name of a specific festival, so proper noun. Before starting with the exercise, you should know the difference between common nouns and proper nouns. Now see children, proper noun refers to a special name for a person, place or a thing. Whereas a common noun refers to a common name for a person, place or a thing. Let us clear this difference by taking some examples. Number one, author. When we talk about author, it refers to the name of a common person, so it is a common noun. But on the other hand, when we talk about Leo Tolstoy, it refers to the name of a particular person, so it is a proper noun. Number two, city. When we talk about city, it refers to the name of a common place, so it is a common noun. On the other hand, when we talk about Paris, it refers to the name of a particular place, so it is a proper noun. Number three, planet. When we talk about planet, it refers to the name of a common planet, so it is a common noun. But on the other hand, when we talk about Neptune, it refers to the name of a particular planet, so it is a proper noun. Number four, language. When we talk about language, it refers to the name of a common language, so it is a common noun. On the other hand, when we talk about Spanish, it refers to the name of a particular language, so it is a proper noun. Children, you have seen the difference that common nouns do not begin with capital letters. On the other hand, proper nouns begin with a capital letter. Now, I will tell you how to do this exercise on your book. Kids, you know, proper noun refers to a name which belongs to a specific or a particular person, place or thing. It always begins with a capital letter. Now, we will do one exercise in which we have to write the sentence putting in capital letters and underline the common nouns also. Read the first example. Sameer is my cousin. Now, kids, you can see Sameer is the name of a particular person, so proper noun. We will make first letter, that is S, capital in this sentence. Now, read the sentence again. Sameer is my cousin. Cousin is the name of a common person, so it is a common noun. We will underline cousin in this sentence. Read the next example. January comes between December and February. Children, you know, January is the name of a particular month, so proper noun. We will make first letter capital, that is J. January comes between December and February. December is the name of a particular month, so we will make first letter capital. February is also the name of a particular month, so it is a proper noun. We will make first letter capital. You can see January, December and February are the proper nouns, so we will have written these months in capital letters. Now read the next example. Tom is my friend. Now children, Tom is the name of a particular person, so it is a proper noun. We will make first letter capital, that is T. Tom is my friend. Friend is the name of a common person, so common noun. We will underline friend as a common noun in this sentence. Now, children, I hope that you have understood the concept of proper noun. You can do the related exercise on your elementary grammar book. Thank you.